Hello! So I'm trying to be better about vlogging because I'm really bad at it. But anyways, I just got a package. Just got a new kitten, which I don't know if I've shown you yet, but I will at some point in the video. And we used to have a cat hammock by the window, but my other cat, Maddie, broke it. So I finally got a new one. It's a different kind. This time it's a wooden one. We really like the wood aesthetic, if you can't already tell. So I got a new one and I'm about to install it. It's a really cool design. I hadn't seen this one yet. So far, the only hammocks that I see are the ones that have the suction cups and it has like some strings that go up and suction up onto the window. And then for this one particularly, there's only suction cups at the bottom. So I'm a little intrigued to see how that works. We'll see if it works. We're gonna see. So here we go. This is the hammock. And we have to install these suction cups here, and then it's going to go on that window right there. So let's get it done. She's like, what is this trickery? I love how they each check each other's food bowl. Like, did you get the same thing? They're so patient.
No.
Hi, hello, it's Sunday morning. We don't really have a busy day today. There's nothing that we're really doing. We just had breakfast and I've had some coffee, so I'm just gonna get ready for the day. Later on, Ben and I are actually going to go get some piercings. So I'm actually going to switch out this little stud and get like a ring, I guess. And then I think I'm gonna get another piercing on my ear so that I have two on my left and then one on my right. We'll see once we get there. I might put it on my right. I'm not sure yet. Eventually, I did want to get the septum piercing and I was going to do that today, but I'm a baby and I'm afraid that it's gonna hurt. So I am holding off on it. So yeah, we're just gonna get ready for right now while I listen to an audiobook. I'm trying to finish my latest audiobook. It's called The Tunnel by Ernesto Sabat, classic from Argentina, about this man's obsession with this woman and then he ends up killing her. It's not a spoiler that he kills her. We know this from the beginning. He's telling us a story of how he fell in love and the reasons why he killed her. So really interesting. Hope to finish that today while I get ready. So yeah, let's do it. Alexa, play Kesi. Si tú me dices ahorita que me quieres a tu lado, qué lindo sería. Si tú con esa boquita ya me tienes embobado, yo te besaría, pero no me dices que sí. Que sí, que sí, que sí. Ay, tú no me dices que sí. Que sí, que sí, que sí. Ay, tú no me dices que sí. Que sí, que sí, que sí. Ay, tú no me dices que sí. Que sí, que sí, que sí. Baby, yeah. What would you do if I got down on my knees? What if I flipped our whole world upside down now? But know that we fit together, you're my queen. Get close to me. I know that it's too soon to have this conversation, but I can't help myself, I'm running out of patience. You know I got you forever, come on, give in to the pleasure. So put up your flags and surrender, you are my treasure, oh yeah, yeah. Si tú me dices ahorita que me quieres a tu lado, qué lindo sería. Si tú con esa boquita ya me quieres embobado, yo te besaría. Pero no me dices que sí, que sí, que sí, que sí. Ay, tú no me dices que sí. Que sí, que sí, que sí. Ay, tú no me dices que sí. Que sí, que sí, que sí. Ay, tú no me dices que sí. Que sí, que sí, que sí. Yo te quiero así tal cual, flow bien natural. Yo te quiero así tal cual, flow bien natural. Yo te quiero así tal cual, flow bien natural. Yo
quiero así tal cual, flow natural. Qué lindo sería, si tu con esa boquita.
By the way, what do you think about your Ember mug?
Oh, it's good.
So I ended up getting Ben this Ember mug for, was it your birthday? And it's supposed to keep your coffee warm because it's cold out here and, you know, you want to have a warm coffee mug. But yeah, so you like it? What's your review?
Hello. Thank you for coming to my review of the Ember mug. I think I have my qualms.
Like what?
Like, I don't like how short the battery life is.
How long does it last for?
Like an hour and a half.
Oh.
I didn't expect it to be that short. I thought this was like a, you know, take with you, keep warm all day kind of thing. It only lasts an hour and a half, so you can't really like bring your coffee with you and keep it warm for long periods of time. And you have to have the little like charging coaster thing in order to charge it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, it's not something you can like bring to work or like anything like that. But I think I've come to adapt to that by using it. So when I work from home, I have the little coaster there and I'll just leave it on top of that. And on top of that, you can keep your coffee warm all day. So for that purpose, it's good. It's just, you have to keep in mind that you're going to have that coaster with you or else you don't really get a charge. Like me out here right now, I kind of took my time with this coffee and it's cold now. No, it's fine. But it like I was too slow with it and I forgot that, you know, the battery was so short. So
I see.
The hour and a half expired and now my coffee is kind of cold. Which, you know, is fine. I'm kind of fine with cold coffee. But yeah, that's definitely something that you need to like take into account when you're getting this because I didn't expect it to be that short.
So today we are going to try something new, something that I've never done, something that I've been wanting to do. And you know, why the hell not? Life's too short to not try things. And if I fuck it up, I fuck it up, I guess. So I've been wanting to paint the edges of my books and just make like designs and stuff. Disclaimer, I am not a painter. I am not an artist. I don't draw. I don't paint. I don't really do anything. But I feel like I want to exercise my creative muscle more. And I feel like this is the only way that I know how to do it. I also eventually want to make some bookmarks. Ben went to Michael's and he bought these like blank bookmarks that you can like draw on and paint on. So eventually I also want to do that. And you're probably asking, why don't you just start off with those instead of ruining a book, potentially? You know, go big or go home. Go big or go home. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do. We're going to start off with ba-bam, in the dream house. So what I'm going to end up doing is just, you know, taking off the cover. Here we go. Taking off the sleeve, I guess, not the cover. And then I'm going to go ahead and wrap the outside so that I don't paint on it with, I don't know, just some Fred Meyer's paper, and then clamp them down. And then I think I'm going to use acrylic paint. I was thinking about doing watercolor at first, but you know, we're gonna go with acrylic, see how it works, and we'll go from there. So this is what it looks like so far. It's not very pretty. I think I used the wrong color of green. I wanted it to look more like this. And then this like mustard yellow on the side, on both the top and then the bottom here. So I'm just gonna let it dry and try to pull it apart tomorrow. So we're back. I'm back with an update and there's definitely some learning lessons to take from this experiment. So first and foremost, I definitely clamped too hard, as you can see here. Keep that in mind. Now I guess I'm just going to go page by page and separate the pages. So this is what the edges look like. I did yellow on one side, green on the other, and then yellow on the other because I thought it would look really cool with the sleeve on. Actually, let me put on the sleeve before I start to separate the pages, that way you're able to see. So here's the book with the sleeve on. So I mean, it actually doesn't look too shoddy. Like, look at that, right? Like, I feel like that looks pretty cool. I mean, I'm definitely not an artist here, so maybe I'll end up adding some other stuff once I think about it a little more. But you know, for now, I'm satisfied. What do you
I think it looks good.
Right? Is there anything choices you would have added?
Added?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I haven't separated it yet.
Yeah, it's like one chunk.
So what I actually ended up doing, because at first the green was too intense that I used on the side, so I actually ended up putting white paint over the green to tone it down.
You can't even tell. It looks really good.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, it's really even too. I don't know.
No, it's not you.
So I just took this, smack myself, leaf back off. Actually, you know, this color of green is very beautiful. I wish I could have mixed this first and then applied that to the edges. I feel like that would have been really beautiful. Next time I'll do that. Check the inside cover color, because I feel like coordinating it to a color already inside of the book would have been a good way to go. So now the hard part is just going page by page and making sure that I don't tear them. I guess something that I can also do just to get them started is just like crunching it. Yeah, right? I feel like, it's pretty much done. Cool. I'll just go through it a little by little tomorrow. Cool. Thank you. So it's been kind of raining all day. I was gonna go outside. Wow, the reflection on my glasses is pretty bad. I was gonna go outside and film for y'all today, but the rain just won't stop. Yeah, I'll have to wait till another day. Life update, today's Sunday. It's 2 days away from my birthday. That's going to be Tuesday. I took the day off so that Ben and I can just go have breakfast. I think we're gonna go on a nice hike, and that's it. Growing up, I just hated celebrating my birthday. I don't know if y'all can hear me over this rain. Let me close the window. So growing up, I always hated celebrating my birthday. I am a shy soul. I'm super introverted. And I remember like one of my friends, like at some point with my mom, made like a surprise birthday party, and they thought I was gonna love it, and I hated it. I'm that kind of person that hates surprise birthday parties, because I'd rather be prepared to know that I need to spend energy with people, because if not, if I'm like having a bad day or if I'm already feeling drained, I'm just gonna leave. I'll just walk away. That, and I just don't like the attention being placed on me even for my birthday. I know like it's supposed to be a day where it's all about you, but I don't like that. I don't like being the center of attention, and that's really weird, right? Because I do have a YouTube channel. So I actually, one of the intentions behind creating this BookTube channel is being comfortable taking up space and being comfortable sharing my opinion, which is something that I've never really been good at, because I'm shy and because I don't want to take up people's time. I don't want to bother anyone. So this channel in itself has helped me grow so much as a person. And I just want to say thank you to everybody that watches and takes their time to just watch through my videos. That honestly, you don't know how much it means to me. That being said, there's 500 of us now. We hit 500 a couple of days ago, and I'm just super excited that there's 500 of you that want to take the time and just sit down and watch my boring videos and are just here and are just here with me on this journey. You know, just like anybody else, I go through moods, I have my ups and downs. There's weeks that I don't post, and then I come back and I post for like 2 weeks straight, and there's like videos every day, and then I'm gone again for like a couple of months. So for those of you who still come back and watch and support, like that means a lot to me, that you realize that I'm also human and I need my breaks and I need my time, and that I'm going through shit too, you know? So thank you so much. And if you haven't introduced yourself yet to this point, say hi. I would love to know that you're here, and I would love to learn something about you, anything that you want to share. So yeah, I guess I'm just feeling very thankful. I think that's one thing that I can appreciate on my birthday, is that I feel very thankful for everything that I have, and you know, just everyone in my life, even though I have difficulty showing it and I'm not very vocal about those things. Like I said, I'm a shy person, and I also keep things bottled up and keep things to myself, but this channel has definitely helped me be more expressive with my emotions and with the way that I'm feeling. And yeah, so again, just really thankful for y'all. Yeah. What can I do?
Hi, so we are at Adorn East. This is the place where we get our piercings done. Ben, as you can tell, is already inside. He had his appointment, so he went in there. We really like this place because they use the needle technique rather than the gun. And apparently that's supposed to be a lot better for the healing process of your skin, and so it doesn't traumatize your skin, and also it reduces the likelihood of an infection. So yeah, we always come here. So I think he's getting both of his ears pierced and he's getting this one switched out. That's what the plan was before he went in. You never know what might happen. So I'm just gonna sit here and read for a little bit in the car while he's in there. My appointment is right after his, so I'll go in there afterwards. So my plan is also to go ahead and change my little stud for a ring, and I might get an additional piercing up here on my ear just to have an extra one. I also wanted to get my septum pierced, but I'm a baby. I'm such a baby. I'm so afraid to get it done. For this little stud here, I cried. I know, I'm such a baby. And like, it's fine now, right? But it's like, in the moment, it's gonna hurt. So yeah, we'll see. We'll see what I do. I'm not entirely sure yet. But yeah, so I'm just gonna wait for Ben to be done with his appointment. In the meantime, I brought options. So the first one is to finish The Murders of Molly Southbourne. This is a short horror novella. I'm about 60% through, so I think I can definitely finish it by the time he's out. So by the time my appointment comes up. Or I also just recently started Little Monsters by Kara Thomas. And I like it so far. It's a YA thriller, I believe. And I think this is also the author of Cheerleaders, or The Cheerleaders, which was popular a couple months ago, I believe, or something like that. So haven't read anything by her. This is going to be the first. They're so beautiful.
Ba ba bum ba ba bum ba ba bum bum ba ba bum ba ba bum ba ba bum bum.
I don't think I've heard the song before. Is this what you listen to while you paint?
No.
Oh.
I was listening to the wall. I think for it.
Nice.
Do 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 do